Hi there, I'm John Bond from Riverwinds Consulting, and this is Publishing Defined. Today I'm going to talk about embargoes in academic publishing. First, an embargo in this usage is a period of time during which access to academic journal articles is not allowed by users who have not paid for access or have met or have access through an institution. A publisher does this to protect the journal's subscription revenue or member benefit. This contention that an embargo period helps protect the business model is obviously debated by many. Surveys have been published that refute this idea. An embargo period might be a few months or years. There are two main types, a so-called moving wall for a fixed period of time, say 12 months. This means that the restricted access is always 12 months, in this instance, from the current date. Another option is a fixed date, such as January 1st of that year. This means that all content prior to that date would require some kind of subscription or membership to view it, but all older content after that date would be freely available in an open access fashion. Prior to the end of any embargo period, the title and other bibliographic information and the abstract would be available to the reader. This embargo on access to scientific content is not to be confused with news embargoes that are commonly applied to the content in health-related news regarding upcoming journal articles, such as in JAMA or The Lancet. Journalists who commonly receive a press release and/or access to the full article must hold back on reporting it until the agreed-upon date. This agreement, sometimes called the Englefinger Rule, allows for research to be done by the journalist prior to publication. Well, that's it. I've released a new ebook called Scholarly Publishing, A Primer. It's a short, focused guide on some of the essential topics that are integral to academic publishing. Starting with the basics of scholarly publishing, it then moves on to the specifics of book and journal publishing, then marketing and promotion, then to organizations and standards, then to rights and licensing, and finally, it looks at trends in publishing. It was born out of videos on this channel. See the link in the notes below for more information on the book or how to purchase it. Hit the like button below if you enjoyed this video, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Or click on the link below to see a video on transitioning a journal to open access. And make comments below or email me with any questions. Thanks so much and take care.